Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am very excited to bring you guys this video because it was very highly requested. I mentioned in many of my videos and also on Instagram that I am an avid lover of self-tanning. I live in Canada, I live in Toronto more specifically, and our weather here is pretty freaking freezing majority of the year. I would say we have about 4 months or 3 months out of the year that are really, really nice and sunbathe worthy. But aside from that, we don't see a lot of sun, basically. So I really depend on really good self-tanners to achieve that faux glow all year round. And to be honest, as a new mom, I don't even have the time to go outside to get a good tan. Not to mention going out in the sun and exposing yourself to UVA and UVB rays is not the healthiest thing that you can do for your skin. And it's also the worst thing you can do for aging. It causes pigmentation and wrinkles, fine lines, all of that stuff that we all don't want. At least I do not want. So I wanna preserve my skin as much as I can. I am a self-professed sun worshiper. I love the sun. I love when it's hot outside. It just re-energizes me to the core, but I know how bad it is for me. So over the years, the more I learn about sun damage, I try to limit my exposure to the sun as much as I possibly can, which is why I love self-tanning so much. It just makes me feel so much better about myself. Because I've been doing it for such a long time, I really learned a lot of tips and tricks on how to achieve a really natural looking faux glow. If you're new to self-tanning, I think that you're gonna find this video super, super helpful because I have a lot of hacks that I wanted to share with you guys to help you achieve a flawless looking tan, and not only achieve a flawless looking tan, but also achieve a very flawless gradual fade out, because that is one of the things that I noticed with a lot of self-tanners. They will look beautiful when you apply them, but once they start to fade out and crackle and flake off, they start to look like alligator skin. So I'm gonna share with you all of my tips and tricks on how to prevent that from happening, and I'm gonna be sharing with you guys honestly the best self-tanner I have found thus far, and I have tested out a lot. Okay, so before I hop into the actual hacks for this video, I quickly wanted to shout out this company that I accidentally stumbled upon. So I am always open and honest with you guys. I pride myself about that. I pride myself for only collaborating with brands that I truly love and actually use myself. I know a lot of influencers just collaborate with brands just to make a quick buck. I'm not about that life. For me, my relationship with my community, with my viewers, with my followers is the most important thing. That's why I would never, ever, ever recommend anything to you guys that I don't believe in. Having said that, as an influencer or creator, if you will, I really hate those terms, but I get sent a lot of PR. I get sent a lot of products to try out all the time, and a lot of brands in turn want me to collaborate with them to share my opinion. Having said all of that, I first of all pick and choose who I choose to receive product from. I'm very choosy. If it's something that I know I'm not gonna use, for example, teeth whitening gel or like a skinny tea detox, I would never accept product from a brand like that versus a brand that reaches out to me and offers me a better product to something that I am already using, such a self-tanner. Of course, I'm gonna try it out and test it out and see how it compares, because sharing this information with you guys is what my channel is all about. I love showing you guys brands and products that I use and love and that have been total game changers for me. So a couple of months ago, this brand reached out to me. They're called EcoTan. It's a company based in Australia. They do a lot of really cool skincare products, and they also have a range of self-tan products. So the reason why I wanted to give this brand a try was because their entire range is said to be organic and natural. And you guys know that I am trying my best to really use products that are as clean and non-toxic as possible. So whenever I find something that has incredible ingredients and also has the effectiveness to back it up, I get so, so excited. So I agree to receive product from EcoTan. really not expecting anything at all, because I have tested out self-tanners in the past that were natural and organic, and even though the ingredients were great, the performance just was not there. It would leave me with either an orange streaky tan, or it would smell really bad. There was always something about it that I just did not like, and I preferred the other self-tanners that I was already using in rotation over the natural and organic ones that I was testing out. So when I received these EcoTan products in the mail, I literally had no expectations. I decided to try out the range that they sent me. I tried out the invisible tan. I tried out the face tan water. So I used the face tan water on my face and the invisible tan on my body. And my immediate reaction was, wow, these don't smell bad at all. They are super easy to apply. Let's see how this goes. Few hours go by. I look at my skin and I kid you not, I have the most natural looking faux glow that I have ever received from a natural and organic product. In addition to that, it actually smelled really, really good in comparison to the other tanners that I have used. It didn't have that fried chicken smell about it, if you know what I mean. And I literally looked like I just got off of a plane from Bali. So when I saw these results, I got super excited and I wanted to see what the wear off would be like the next day or the following day or a week later. You guys, this stuff stays on your skin for a week or two. It fades so, so beautifully. I do use a trick that I will share with you later on in this video that I help to prolong my tan and also help with the fade out. But even without that trick, these products are just such a game changer. I was so taken aback from the results from using these products that I, of course, reached out to the company and I said, you guys, I don't know how you are formulating your products, but they are absolutely amazing. And I want to know how I can support you and how we can work together. So I am so, so, so excited to let you guys know that I have another genuine partnership that I have built with EcoTan. And I'm so excited to be sharing these products with you because they are honestly so amazing. And I wish that more people would talk about these, because not only are the ingredients absolutely incredible, but the performance and the effectiveness is there. So in addition to this partnership that I have with EcoTan, they are offering my subscribers a 20% site-wide discount using the code NIKKILOVES. I'll leave all the information across the screen here and also my description box down below if you do want to check them out. I'm telling you guys, if you are a self-tan addict like I am and you're looking for a more natural and also healthier alternative, you cannot go wrong with these products. I thought it was really important to preface that to let you know why I decided to feature EcoTan in this video when I could have featured any other self-tanning company in this video. I just love these products so much and I see such a huge difference with them, and they are a small company that I really, really wanted to shout out and partner with, and I am so, so excited for you guys to try them out. So let's hop into the first hack. The first hack is to make sure that you exfoliate your skin really, really well. You want to exfoliate your face if you will be self-tanning your face, and you want to, of course, exfoliate your entire body. So the product that I've been using to do that is another EcoTan product. This is something that I tried out after their self-tanning products. Now, it's one thing for a brand to create incredible self-tan products. It's another thing to also create incredible skincare. I honestly also had no expectations for this, but when I first tried it, it was like a spa experience in my bathroom. This scrub is hands down one of the best scrubs I've ever tried in my life. It smells amazing, the texture is amazing, and the best part is you can use it on your face and your body. And it says hands too. So it's like a 3-in-1. It's super, super effective. And it really does a great job at exfoliating your skin and getting off any dead skin cells and making sure you have a beautifully prepped smooth canvas for the self-tan application. So I like to use this in the shower before I use my body wash, and I also focus this on the areas of my skin where I know that my self-tan tends to grab onto a lot more. So that is something, if you are a newbie to self-tanning, you will learn over time what your dry spots are. For me, for example, it's my hands, it's my elbows, it's my knees, and it's also around my feet. And those are very, very common areas for a lot of people to not only have more delicate skin and have the self-tan stick to those areas a lot more. And the reason for that is because the skin in those areas tends to be a lot more thin. So that's why I take the extra time to make sure that I am exfoliating all of those dry spots a lot more than other areas of my body. Another thing that is going to help you exfoliate the dry areas of your body is an exfoliating glove like this. And you guys, I don't know who formulates the products for EcoTan and who designs all of their accessories, but whoever is doing it is doing an incredible job. Like, the quality of this is honestly the best exfoliating mitt I have ever used. And again, I have used a lot. I love how it fits super snug around your wrist and it doesn't fall off like a lot of them do. I also love that it has like one of these little string hooks, so you can hook it on to your shower. All of the exfoliating mitts and the tanning mitts that I've ever used didn't have one of these things, and it's just such a simple thing to add on, because I hate when my mitts just have nothing to hook onto and just fall on my shower floor. It's not the most hygienic thing. And this way, my mitt has a place of its own in my shower. So I love using this if I need like an extra exfoliation of certain areas. And I also like using it in between tans when I shower, because let's say I go overboard and one of my dry areas is a lot more tan than I would like it to be, I kind of use this like a tan eraser to remove any excess tan from that area. The next hack is to make sure that you moisturize those dry areas really, really well. So like I've already mentioned, my dry areas tend to be my hands, my elbows, my knees, and the tops of my feet. So I really take the time to make sure I use a good moisturizer to moisturize all those areas. So what this hack does is create a barrier on your skin. The self-tan is still gonna absorb into those areas, but it's going to absorb a lot less. So it's gonna make your tan look a lot more even and a lot more flawless if you make sure that you moisturize your dry areas. Now, just like the body, you wanna make sure that you also moisturize your face. With the face, I noticed that if I use a moisturizer that is a little too thick, the self-tan won't grab on as well. It's not gonna be as effective, and you're gonna wash your face one or two times and it's gonna be as if you never self-tanned your face. So when it comes to applying self-tan to the face, I like to use a thinner self-tan. That way the self-tan will be a lot more effective when I apply it to my face. All right, so my next hack is for when you are actually applying self-tan to the face. So this is what I use to self-tan my face. This is the EcoTan Face Tan Water, and it's literally like a water. So I personally like to use it on a cotton pad. So I'll put some drops onto the cotton pad and then I will put it on my face. So the first hack is to make sure that you avoid your upper lip area and your under eye area. Why do you want to do this? That's because the skin on your upper lip area and under your eyes tends to be thinner than the rest of the skin on your face. So first of all, it's going to absorb more of the self-tan than the rest of your face. And I doubt that you want to look like you have a mustache over your lip or accentuate your under eye circles. So if you avoid those areas altogether, it's going to make your face tan look a lot more natural. The next hack that I like to do is kind of contour my face. Now, this is completely optional, but I thought that for some of you who maybe want to create a more natural looking chiseled look on your face, this is a great hack. So what I do is I take the cotton pad with the face tan water on it and I kind of fold it halfway and I chisel out my cheekbones. So the natural contour that I have in my face right under my cheekbone, I like to add extra face tan right there and also right under my jawline. And sometimes I like to go along the sides of my nose to make my nose appear smaller. So that's just a little trick that I wanted to share with you guys if you wanted to make your face look a little bit more chiseled naturally. And you can do it all with face tan. My next hack when it comes to tanning your face is not only gonna help you achieve a more flawless looking face tan, but it's going to prevent you from being a dead giveaway that you face tanned. And that is to not forget your ears. Never, ever, ever forget your ears. I've seen so many women make this mistake where they would face tan their face and their neck and their shoulders and their chest, and they would forget about their ears, and their ears would just stick out like an eyesore. And if you think about it, when you naturally get sun-kissed from the sun, your ears tan too. So make sure you don't forget that area and just take whatever is left over on your cotton pad, if you're gonna be using a cotton pad like I do, and just put the remainder of the product on your ears. You don't need a lot. You definitely don't want to saturate the cotton pad, because if you saturate it, your ears are going to be three shades lighter than the rest of your face and your body. Because again, the skin on your ears is a lot more thin than the rest of the skin on your face and your body, and it's just going to absorb a lot more of the self-tan than anything else. Okay, so let's move on to my self-tan hacks for tanning the body. So the first thing that you want to do is use circular motions to apply the tan. You never want to go up and down, because this is going to create that really dreaded streaky look that you definitely do not want. So first thing is, you always want to make sure that you use circular motions. And the next thing you want to do, which is very, very important, is make sure that you only go over your hands and feet with whatever is left over on your mitt. You never want to apply self-tan to your mitt and then go on your hand or on your feet first, because like I mentioned, the skin on your hands is going to absorb it a lot more, and your hand is gonna be way darker than the rest of your limbs. So focus majority of the tan on your limbs, and then whatever is left over, just go over your hands and your feet and your knees and your elbows and whatever other areas of your body that tend to be very dry. So sorry you guys, my camera just stopped working. I don't know what is going on with it, but it's not turning on, so I have to film the remainder of this video on my iPhone. So I really, really hope that the video and the sound quality is okay, and I'm so, so, so sorry. I have to get my husband to take a look at my camera to see what's going on, but hopefully it is not broken, because with the current situation that the world is in right now, finding a camera is probably going to be a nightmare. The trick that I discovered is best for making sure that your hands and your feet look as natural as possible, specifically your hands, is when you're going over your hands, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you're going in between each of your fingers, and then you want to bend your knuckles so that you can get in between those little wrinkles on your fingers. You also want to avoid the nail bed as much as possible, because those tend to stain really, really badly, and it's going to be an obvious giveaway that you used self-tan. So I always kind of like graze over my nails when I go on my hands, and I always make sure to bend my knuckles and go in between the fingers to make sure that I don't miss anything. And when it comes to the palms, I like to make sure that I go over them with a wet, either wet cotton pad with just water, or like a makeup remover wipe, just to make sure I remove any leftover self-tan on my hands. And I'm showing you my hands right now and looking at them and realizing how dry they are, because I have been washing them and sanitizing them non-stop. So I truly apologize if my hands look worse for wear right now, and that's because they are. But considering the fact that I probably wash them like 80 times a day, my self-tan is looking pretty good. So I kind of touched on my next hack in my previous hack, and that is to use a makeup remover wipe or a wet cotton pad to remove any self-tanner on areas that you don't want to tan. So you can do the palms of your hands, you can do the bottoms of your feet. I can't really think of any other areas where you would want to remove the self-tan, but sometimes you might have a dry patch, for example, that you forgot to exfoliate. I tend to have that around my hairline, where my neck is. So in that case, I will just take a makeup remover wipe and really just like scrub that area really well after I've self-tanned. That way the self-tan won't grab onto that area so much and it's going to fade it out really naturally and it's gonna blend everything in together much better. My next hack is pretty much the final step of the whole self-tan process. And that is, first of all, wait 5 minutes before getting dressed to make sure that you don't transfer your self-tan onto your clothes and create patches on your self-tan. But with EcoTan, I find that these products dry so fast that you can really wait like maybe 2-3 minutes before getting dressed and you should be fine. And the main thing is wear loose fitting clothes for the entire day, because if you wear something too fitted or too tight, it's not only going to create like weird marks in your skin, but it's also going to remove any self-tan, so you're not gonna get the full effects from it. So I like just throw on a sweatsuit to roam around my house in and try to wait for as long as possible before taking a shower. I usually like self-tanning early in the morning and then I will wash it off late at night right before I go to bed. Some people like to sleep in their self-tan. I personally don't, especially because I have a little baby that I have to bring into my bed sometimes to breastfeed. I just like to make sure that my sheets are clean for that reason. And lastly, I wanted to throw in a bonus tip or a bonus hack, and this is how to make sure that your self-tan fades out as flawlessly and naturally as possible. And that is to moisturize, moisturize, moisturize. I cannot emphasize that enough. That is honestly the secret to making sure that you don't get alligator skin. So get yourself a really, really good moisturizer. I personally like to use a body oil. I make my own body oil. So I have this beautiful bottle of apricot seed oil and I just add in a few drops of lemongrass because I love the scent of lemongrass. And every time I get out of the shower, I just slather my skin from head to toe in this body oil and it preserves my tan so, so well. I kid you not. I can get away with having the self-tan last on me for 1 to 2 weeks. Okay guys, so that wraps up today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it and found these tips and tricks really helpful. And I really, really hope you give EcoTan a try because they are just incredible. Their products are so, so good. And it's a small company based in Australia and I've never heard anyone talk about them before. And I feel like they really, really need the love and recognition because they're just doing incredible things. I always get so excited to talk about these kind of like hidden gem brands that no one else has talked about before, and this one is no exception. So again, I'm gonna leave my code across the screen and also link it in my description box below for any of you guys who want to check it out. If you are new to my channel, it would mean so much to me if you would consider subscribing. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and if you have any questions that I didn't answer in this video, please leave them for me in the comments below and I will do my best to answer them. As always, I want to thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out with me, and I will see you in my next one.